Welcome to episode 4 of Inside Azure for IT. I'm Erin Chapple, CVP of Azure Core Product and Design. Now, innovation is at the heart of what we do at Microsoft. We continually push the limits of what technology can accomplish because we've seen the amazing things that you can do with it. In this episode, we're going to get a behind-the-scenes perspective on how three businesses are using cutting-edge technologies like high-performance computing, Azure Quantum, and AI to power innovation and generate new kinds of business impact. Whether it's an animation and visual effects studio like Jellyfish Pictures, NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory, or a self-flying air taxi company like Volocopter, innovative Azure capabilities are helping change the way people do business and influencing others in their industries to do the same. In this first segment, we'll chat with Jeremy Smith and Karla Young from Jellyfish Pictures, one of the world's largest animation and visual effects studios. They'll share how they create the amazing visuals we see in movies like How to Train Your Dragon, Homecoming, or some of the most recent Star Wars films. Using Azure high-performance computing to accelerate image rendering, they have to spin up tens of thousands of cores at a moment's notice and manage all of that rich content securely and in a single place without replication. Now, in our second segment, we'll talk with members of the Azure Quantum team about how they took a quantum-inspired approach to scheduling optimization challenges for NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory. And in our third segment, we'll discuss how Volocopter, a pioneer in providing air taxi and drone services in urban environments, is building a cloud-native solution to integrate with smart cities and existing mobility operations using Azure infrastructure and AI. Now I'd like to welcome Jeremy Smith, Chief Technology Officer, and Karla Young, Head of PR, Marketing, and Communications at Jellyfish Pictures. Welcome, Jeremy and Karla. I'm delighted you can join me on Inside Azure for IT.
Thanks, Erin. I'm excited to be here.
Thanks for having us, Erin.
Now, through our partnership, we've learned about the challenges you face in visual effects and animation work, which is typically project-based. Traditionally, artists would do the vast majority of their work on-premises due to just the huge amount of compute capacity that's needed for rendering and the security measures required to protect intellectual property. And when the pandemic hit, this model posed a big challenge. Can you talk about how Jellyfish adapted to accommodate remote work and maintain business continuity?
Sure. Well, when the pandemic first hit, when very many of studios in our industry were having to implement freezes or being forced to lay off employees, Jellyfish actually hired 200 people from across 20 different countries. Thankfully, we'd already moved large portions of our business to the cloud starting back in 2016. So we were able to scale and adapt pretty quickly to power a more remote workforce. In this industry, talent isn't an infinite resource. So being able to recruit artists regardless of their physical location was a huge advantage. In many ways, talent is our biggest driver of growth. So the fact that people were able to work safely, securely, and productively in their own technological environment with Azure allowed us to continue to deliver this superior work to our clients. Not to mention that artists were probably happier to not be back in an office full of the heat and loud machine noises of servers sitting under their desks.
Yeah, I completely agree, Karla. I remember one of the first projects we worked on during the pandemic, where we used Azure Virtual Scalesys to replicate a single image across 500 nodes. We used the HBV2 series VM, and these were spread over Ireland, the Netherlands, and the United States. There's no way we could have delivered that project without that broad footprint. All of our artists around the globe experienced the same low latency and high performance they've come to expect.
You know, that's just an awesome transformation, right? Going from creating work despite technology limitations to innovating and creating amazing work because of the technology, and specifically that global cloud-based infrastructure. You know, that's really at the heart of what digital transformation is all about, and I hear that constantly from customers. Now, enabling a remote workforce has been so important over the last few years, and in many cases, that has generated additional benefits, like the ones you mentioned. Jeremy, in addition to improving the work environment and helping Jellyfish recruit and employ people globally, cost-effective computing power via the cloud can help with that efficiency and compute performance. What's your experience been with that, and how has it impacted the business?
Well, that's one of the really great advantages of moving to the cloud is that you always get the latest hardware. You know, lately we've been using the HB120s and the HB60 VM SKUs. These are armed with the newest AMD EPYC processors, and we've used them for rendering. The performance that we got out of these chips was absolutely colossal. However, I'd say the most impactful thing that we've tapped into on Azure is the High Performance Compute, or HPC, platform. Azure HPC Cache and Azure VM Scale Sets gives us a ton of agility and flexibility, which has helped us deliver projects that require massive computational resources. In fact, on the last project that we worked on, we topped up about 90,000 processor cores with Azure Scale Sets on the HBV2 series VMs. This was coupled along with Azure VFXT and the Azure Spot VMs. By doing this, it actually helped knock 80% off the rendering cost when taking these workloads to the cloud. To keep the latency low, we use Azure Express Route to really minimize and optimize that network connectivity. This helped manage our storage all in a secure environment, and it kept everything under one roof, so there was really no need for any replication.
You know, that's what I love about Azure. It's a cloud that's built for HPC. You get optimized compute, network, and storage resources that can really unlock a whole new level of value and versatility. And HPC is such a wide range of use cases. We see customers using it to rapidly iterate on product design, to reduce time to market, or simulate vehicle engineering, or even accelerate insights from health research. Now, you've mentioned security a few times. There has to be a certain level of confidentiality that's involved when you're working on motion pictures and similar projects. I mean, keeping the details of those highly anticipated films top secret to preserve the surprise is critical. Now, when you made the decision to move to the cloud, were there special security features you considered? And how did you overcome any concerns that you might have had?
Well, certainly, Erin. Protecting intellectual property is a huge priority for any studio. To be eligible for certain projects, we have to be accredited by organizations like the Trusted Partner Network, which often follows rules from the Motion Picture Association. When we first started virtualizing the studio in 2016, Azure was the first hyperscale multi-tenant cloud service platform to successfully complete a formal assessment by the MPA and comply with their best practices. Because Azure is certified by the MPA and customer data is stored in a locked down environment, in many ways, our data is even more secure than it was on premises.
Karla, it's a great example of how moving to the cloud can help strengthen your security posture. Now, moving to the cloud can also help with scalability. Right? No matter the industry, the amount of compute capacity it takes to run a business is going to vary from time to time. For example, you know, mission-critical workloads may need to run nonstop, whereas other applications can handle those interruptions. You know, what does flexibility give you in terms of business impact, and what does that translate to, Jeremy?
So when a studio scales up to work on a large feature film, it invests in like hardware, software, and the recruitment of hundreds of artists. When the project is complete and the studio scales back down, it is still committed to that really expensive and specialized hardware. At that point, studios can either try and get maximum utilization out of that hardware investment or opt for the flexibility offered by the cloud solutions.
Studios are all competing for a small pool of top talents from across the globe. But if they're restricted by on-premises capacity, they can be forced to turn down big projects because they're not able to scale their infrastructure swiftly and efficiently.
That's exactly right, Karla. With Azure Service Flexibility, we can put the needs of the production first, hiring the best creatives for each task, no matter where they live geographically. And when the project is over, we simply shut it off. We aren't stuck with on-premise hardware investments that consume air conditioning, square footage, power, and so on. All this otherwise would be underutilized waiting for the next production.
That sounds like a game changer for Jellyfish, but also for the industry. You know, on-demand cloud resources are enabling so much more agility these days, and it's inspiring for me to see how our services can also help IT become just as flexible and adaptive as the people that they're supporting. Now, we've talked about how virtualization has improved many pieces of the animation and visual effects process. How has technology really enabled innovation at Jellyfish, Jeremy?
We are in a creative industry. While producing the highest quality of work is paramount, the art that inspires the work is equally important. Because of the way these projects are released and promoted, we are often, you know, working against immovable deadlines, which can put a lot of pressure on the artist to speed up the entire creative process. Using things like burst rendering in Azure, we've been able to push those deadlines to the absolute limit and leave more time for the creative process. Being able to burst to the cloud immediately significantly decreases the amount of waiting time we face during the rendering process while increasing the iterative ability that we have. We've gained the equivalent of an additional 70% capacity of our own data center, which helps us scale up massively at a moment's notice without any long-term CapEx commitments.
These are such great points, Jeremy. And you know, the concept of deadlines putting pressure on the quality of work is something I think everyone can relate to. We all want to be more agile, and the cloud can help us respond to big challenges like the ones we've experienced over the past 2 years. Now that you've gone through your own transformation, I'm curious, what would you say to leaders in similar industries who are considering moving their business to the cloud?
Well, what it comes down to is the artists that this technology is serving and the benefits that it brings to them. They're able to focus on their best work instead of worrying about how long it's going to render complex shots like running water or hair. And when the outside world sees this work and what they've produced, I think they think it's akin to magic. But what they don't recognize is that it takes a lot of hard work and dedicated talent that goes to producing these visuals that audiences fall in love with and connect to. So we want to make sure that our teams have better lives and they're able to focus on what they love without any additional stress. And that's what truly makes our work shine.
Well, as someone who benefits from the magic, it's a delight every time I get to experience a new animated film. So thank you for your work. And Jeremy, Karla, it was wonderful to have you here on the show. I can't wait to see the exciting projects that Jellyfish Pictures gets to work on in the future.
Thank you so much.
It's been great. Thank you, Erin.
Now, don't forget to check out the other segments of this episode of Inside Azure for IT. We have Anita Ramanan and Victor Weiss from the Microsoft Azure Quantum team coming to talk about the project they worked on with NASA. And we'll also chat with Alex Uhling, the chief digital officer at Volocopter. So for all our videos, deep dives, and skilling content, head to azure.com/insideazure for IT. I'll see you next time.